Is it fair to say that the reason why you used Metaverse is because it's a representation of a more diversified data sources and data types?
Absolutely. So when you think of games how they used to be, you know, when I was a kid, you had Super Mario 64, and you had a cartridge, and you just put it in the console, and that was it. There was nothing coming in from outside, nothing leaving. It was just completely, you know, self-contained. Nowadays, mm-hmm. when you look at some of the most cutting-edge games that are out there, especially some of the Web3 games, there's so many different moving parts. You can have a wallet that can store different NFTs. Those NFTs can unlock abilities in-game and different skins and things like that. Mm-hmm. So you need to be able to track that. You also want to know, you know, what players are doing in the game, so you have information mm-hmm. that comes out of Unity or Unreal and that you have to keep track of. Mm-hmm. But then there's the next step, right, which is, you know, do people who buy this NFT enjoy the game more than people who don't buy this NFT? And then you have to be able to tie, you know, the user and their wallet to what they're doing in the game, to be able to filter certain kinds of game data by NFT data, etc. So mm-hmm. the more data sources you have, the more complex the analysis becomes, especially for somebody who's not an engineer. Mm-hmm. And this is what we really focus on at Datawisp.
A lot of those metaverse companies or projects, they are in the very early stage. Yeah. So do you think this will impact the business growth of Datawisp?
We actually like that they're early, because mm-hmm. the earlier that we get to talk to these people that are building certain projects, the better a shot we have at, you know, building from the beginning things that are useful to them and things that meet their needs. It also gives us an opportunity to educate them about data science and the importance of collecting, you know, clean, consistent data, because you know how it is in the early stages. Sometimes people just like rig things up to make it work for the time being, and then they end up kind of stuck that way. And so that's long-term not good for business. There's a couple of clients that we work with, for example, they're really big companies that have been around for a while. Mm-hmm. And, you know, because they've been doing certain things wrong for a really long time, they just kind of have layers and layers of things to patch up the mistakes. Mm-hmm. And they never have time to go back and, like, fix all these things. Mm-hmm. So it's very important to do it right from the beginning, because it saves you a lot of time and money. And also, whatever tool you choose to work with, whether it's Datawisp or something else, if you're working with clean data from the beginning, it's always easier.
That means for basic or entry-level data analytics, that will be handled by the Datawisp. But for more advanced machine learning algorithms or customized mm-hmm. solutions, that will be developed by the companies themselves.
There's always going to be a data scientist or somebody who works at a company who's going to be able to do stuff more specifically tailored to the company than us, obviously, because, you know, we're just serving a SaaS product, right? Mm-hmm. So let's say you can do 98% of what you need to do with Datawisp. There's always going to be 2% that is best done by an engineer. What we want to do is to be able to give them all the tools that they need to have the time to do those things. Mm-hmm. And also another, you know, we have features that we're planning that help engineers do those kinds of things. So for example, when you look into our product, there's all these blocks that transform data. Mm-hmm. Right now, we just have the blocks that we've provided. But in the future, engineers will be able to write their own blocks and save them for their teams to use, right? So if there's something that we overlooked that is very important for a customer, mm-hmm. their engineers can make it happen for the rest of their team. Mm-hmm. And then that block basically becomes part of the platform, and everybody else on the team can use it without having to rewrite it from scratch. Mm-hmm. So in that way, you know, we kind of enable them to focus on the harder to hit, you know, more like niche problems.